Look into my eyes. You are getting sleepy. You are getting sleepy.
You are getting at least $1,000 worth of federal funding. Yep, that's a thing, apparently.
Yes, back in January, in Senate estimates, it was revealed that the Federal Health Department had paid for at least two staff to get hypnotherapy to help them quit smoking at a cost of around $1,000. Increasingly, corporations and workplaces, like, for example, Deakin University, are paying for staff to get hypnotherapy to help them go smoke-free. But just how well proven is it?
If you look at the evidence, hypnotherapy does work for some very precise things, like, for example, bed wetting in children, pain relief for people who know that they're going to endure pain, getting them ready for that sort of thing. But for a large number of indications where claims are made about hypnotherapy, the evidence shows it doesn't work, and smoking cessation is one of those.
Today's miracles are tomorrow's science. My name is Lyndall Briggs. I'm the president of the Australian Society of Clinical Hypnotherapy. I've been president for 10 years. Hypnosis is a state of mind. It's a brainwave state. It's in the alpha state, basically. Hypnotherapy is using any sort of therapy in that state.
All right, I'm just still trying to wrap my head exactly around how it works. How does hypnotherapy work on someone?
I sort of bore you to death. No, sorry. No, I pop you in my chair and I talk to you about your breathing and I get you into a relaxed state so that your mind actually goes, oh my God, is she still going? All right, and your mind, your cognitive, conscious mind sort of drifts off.
So there's no pendulums?
Maybe you wouldn't appreciate this, but sometimes things on TV aren't altogether true.
No.
Sorry.
You, no.
Whilst the evidence for smoking might be questionable, there is published research that suggests hypnotherapy can help with reducing pain associated with certain kinds of cancer, arthritis, skin complaints like eczema, and a randomised control trial has presented evidence that hypnotherapy could even help with irritable bowel syndrome.
All conditions have an emotional component. So if you've got a broken leg, okay, we can work a little bit with speeding up the healing, for sure.
Sorry, she can heal what now?
You actually get somebody into a relaxed state and you talk to the control centre of their brain. So if it's pain, you turn up the endorphins, you turn down the adrenaline, you do all these sort of things.
When you say you speak to the control centre in your brain,
yep.
What does that mean?
Once the person is in that relaxed state, they can access it. I mean, where do you get your daydreams from? Where do you get your imagination from? That's my job, is to teach you.
Lyndall offers hypnotherapy courses in everything from getting over an ex.
I look ugly. No, I don't.
To confidence.
I'm not afraid anymore.
Great golf.
Blushing.
Getting pregnant with IVF.
Never ceases to amaze me how it works, but it does.
Luck.
She can probably make people feel that things that have happened to them are lucky things.
We introduce you to your guardian angel.
Magnificent breasts. Really?
Yes.
Absolute nonsense.
Takes them back to a time of pre-puberty.
Nonsense.
You're talking to the construction workers.
I've got better things to do than the time.
Bigger and better.
So, we decided, let's give it a shot. There's just one problem. I don't smoke. Also, I think I could probably get through life with breasts that lack magnificence. There is, however, one thing I do absolutely need. I need a house. See, here's the thing. I live in Sydney. Yes, you should feel free to judge me, but the thing is, you can't afford anything in this town unless you're a cocaine dealer or an NRL player or maybe both. Anyways, tonight, I'm going to go bid on a house. The first time I've ever bid on anything outside of eBay, and I am terrified. I'm just hoping that maybe hypnotherapy can help.
You know, generally this is not a spectator sport.
Yep, no, that's, I appreciate that. That's okay. Why I'm just hugging the pillows.
That's why the pillows are there.
First, the talking. It's mostly kind of childhood fears, hopes, dreams, golf theory.
I think golfers are the warriors of our new world.
And then it begins.
Oh, I put music on. Is that a problem?
No.
Oh, good.
Is it chanting? Please tell me it's chanting.
This machine, what this does is tells me how relaxed you are.
Is it blood pressure? Is that what it's reading?
No, it's what they call a galvanic skin resistor, which
oh,
measures
like,
moisture.
The same technology behind lie detector tests.
Exactly. We just have to have it stable. So I'd actually talk to you for a few minutes about nothing, like about what did you eat for breakfast. Then I'd ask you to imagine something quite stressful, and I would watch the numbers go up, and then I would have a range. Then I get you into a relaxed state, then we do the actual work. Okay. And I want you to just be aware now of the sounds in the room. Sound of me moving from time to time, maybe even sounds from outside, passing traffic. But just for now, that's not going to bother you because you're just going to take these few minutes just for you. Just breathing in pure relaxation, exhaling anything unlike relaxation. No matter how often. But what I'm looking at is like for luck and confidence. And also to use your past experiences in other areas where you've been successful. You know, I'd like you to imagine yourself going to a peaceful place, to that place where you know how to create what you desire, that you can make certain changes, changes that will bring about the kind of results that you want. Now I'm going to count from 1 to 5, and on the count of 5, you'll find yourself becoming fully awake. Open your eyes, take a deep breath. Can you explain to me hypnotherapy now?
No.
How do you feel about the auction today?
Chilled.
I feel like I had an awesome nap. I don't know how much time that took. I don't even know if I should be driving a car, let alone bidding on a house. That was so strange. All right. We're gonna crash the car. Driver's side's that way. Gotcha. It's gonna end well.
If you believe that something is going to make you better, a certain percentage of people will get better through sheer virtue of that belief.
Placebos work great. They actually work better than a lot of drugs. I mean, if it works, does it matter?
And don't have a house. I'm gonna have to pursue that secondary career of being a drug dealer after all. Hey! At least I didn't crash the car. So there's that.